Thanks to technology, solutions are being created to avert climate change, and some of those areas where technology is helping is sustainable housing. Today I'm excited to bring to you an expert who is leading the way in creating sustainable housing that is scalable, affordable to some extent, here in Uganda. My name is Francis Emukule, and welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. Welcome to the show, sir.
Thank you for inviting me on this show. I'm happy to be here. My name is Brian Kurubia.
What's your name?
My name is Brian Kurubia, and I work with Easy Housing as a junior forest officer as well as sales officer.
So I want you to take us through this journey slowly by slowly, because from the look of things, since I came here, this felt like something foreign. Yes. So tell me, what does Easy Housing do? What do you guys basically specifically focus on?
Yeah, in fact, this is something real, not for real. Easy Housing is a circular and bio-based building concept based on sustainable resourced timber. We build affordable houses using timber that has been sourced from well-managed forests. As Easy Housing, we envision a world where everyone has access to a comfortable and a sustainable home. Yeah, that's our vision.
So what do you mean by sustainable?
Yeah, we are sustainable in a way that the timber we are using in the construction is sourced from well-managed forests. For instance, we don't source timber from anywhere, much as people have planted the trees, but we are pushing for these people to plant, and by planting we shall source it from well-managed forests. For instance, let me give you an example. The timber which we are using for building these affordable homes, we source it from Busoga Forestry Company in Mayuge, which is a subsidiary of Green Resources, because the way they manage their plantations even promotes the long-term health of the plantations, meaning that even when they harvest, they will replant and create demand for more trees to be established. Yes.
What type of wood do you guys basically use?
Yeah, for instance, here in Uganda, basically the type of wood that we are using is pine timber. Some call it Pinus caribea. The reason as to why we are using pine is because of its short cycle when it comes to the growth.
Pine maturity period.
Yeah, the maturity period. For our weather here in Uganda is very favorable for plantation establishment. Pine takes around 15 years, and by 15 years you are cutting, and basing on the forest management plan, you can even keep on replanting and replanting. So that's why we saw timber, pine timber, as a very good species here. And also the woodworkers, they find it easy to work with compared to other wood species, but also its availability. Ugandans have now planted very many hectares and hectares of trees, so we are kind of adding value to these trees that have been planted some time back.
So it's easy for you guys to outsource here and there?
It's easy. I can say it's easy, but currently we are so strict in where we are sourcing our timber, because we don't want to cause deforestation. What I mean by deforestation, we cannot just come and take timber from your plantation because you have a lot. We need to check your criteria for the sustainability. For instance, here we have a factor that we are talking about called forest certification, FSC. So most of the partners we are working with currently, they are FSC certified, meaning that they cater for all those activities that are not going to damage the environment, not damage the people they are working with and the communities. So FSC certification is very important when we are to take timber from your plantation. And I can tell you that actually each home we are building here in Uganda contributes to sustainable management of a football field that is full of trees through our partners.
That's a very intricate statement you've made. I need you to go further and explain.
I think the easiest measurement I can use here could be square meters. So when we are building a single home, we can sustain about 7,000 square meters of the forest area. Meaning that these people, when we go and buy timber from them, because they have seen that easy housing is using timber to build affordable homes, they will know, like just like a person who is planting coffee, they know that there is demand for my product. After harvesting, I have to replant. So they will replant the same area, about 7,000 square meters. I have used an example of a football field because I know most people
can relate.
Yeah, can relate to the football area, as you see a football pitch. So that's the area of trees that these people are replanting every time we get timber from them. Now imagine we are building 100 homes. That's the equivalent of around 100 football fields that have been replaced. So we believe that this model is one way of reducing pressure on natural forests like Mabila, Budongo, which we know that their trees like mahogany can take about 45 years to start seeing something. But for pine, 15 years you are having something.
So, you know, initially I thought that as long as I have the trees that you need, there shouldn't be any problem. You should be able to take the trees and, you know, it's a funesente zang. But I'm surprised again you're saying I have to be certified in a way. So meaning, not anybody that has trees will qualify for you guys to be, you know, to source from. And I'm interested to know, why is that very important? Because if I have trees, why is it your business to know if they are certified or not?
Yeah. It's our business to know that you are certified or not, because we know very well that if you already have your trees, you planted, let's say 10 acres, and tell us, is there housing, there is timber here. First of all, we don't know how you have been managing your timber in terms of the forest management.
What do you mean, forest management?
Forest management, like which kind of chemicals have you been using to control the weeds? Are they ending up into the rivers? We want to create a situation whereby there is coexistence between we human beings and the surroundings of the environment. So FSC certification is an international body that came up to bring about all these, about six principles, ensuring that for you to be a tree grower, you must be at least having all these principles put in practice to ensure that you are not causing harm to the environment, the people you are working with, if it comes to labor. Then you are also having a management plan that every time I will cut this compartment, I will replant, so that there is that sustainability cycle continues, something like that. And that's why we are very serious about it.
Now, you hinted a little bit earlier that a studio house is about 29 million Uganda shillings?
Yeah, thank you so much. A studio house costs 34.9 million.
34.9 million, that is 35.
About 35. But when you compare actually to other...
Okay, what comes with a studio house?
Yeah,
bring it down.
What comes to the studio house, we build what we call a core and shell. Here we build the house with the paintworks done, the doors are there for the outside and the inside. It has the bathroom, but the bathroom, what we don't put in are the fittings for you,
like the sink and everything.
Yeah, those installments within the bathroom, we call it the sanitary furniture, they are not put. Then the electricity and plumbing, those are additional options which we can discuss as an additional price. The reason as to why we leave it out is because sometimes you, a client, you may say, I may get another service provider to fix that for me. But if you wish to continue with easy housing, still we can do and give you a complete house.
Is that the starting price? Like, it just looks a bit expensive. 34.9. It's quite a lot, man. Especially if you're saying that you're doing sustainable housing, because I believe that if you're going to do sustainable housing, you're actually creating a cheaper solution to solving a problem of housing. But again, at the end of the day, you're trying to push for promotion of, you know, environmentally sustainable building solutions. Now, I'd expect that that would be a little bit, you know, cheap.
Yeah, thank you for bringing this point out. Actually, I can assure you that we are the most affordable housing solution so far in the market. Uganda has a housing deficit of 2.4 million units.
Yes.
These are the houses that are needed. But I can assure you that when you come and you see the you see the prices of houses in Kampala around here, for instance, prices around Kampala, you'll see an apartment going for around 200 million. Now, a typical Ugandan, how can a typical Ugandan who doesn't even earn 5 million per month, how will he or she ever be able to afford such a house? So now we are, if we are talking about 34.9, that's a fair price for sure. And you are getting a comfortable home that's going to last for over 100 years.
This wood is going to last for 100 years?
Yes, it's going to last 100 years. Why? The preservation given to this timber has been treated to ensure that things like termites, the weather conditions, things like fires, those ones have been catered for to ensure that the structure can last for over 100 years. You know, the oldest structures in Uganda, in actually the whole world, the oldest timber structures can be found in Japan, but even here in Uganda, we have structures that people have not been actually talking about. For instance, the oldest timber houses in Makerere, which were built in around 1913, they have been standing for around 93 years. And these structures, when you look at them, you may think they have just built last year. So this kind of timber construction is something that was in existence, but people were not giving it attention. And so we are bringing it again and again.
You know why I'm laughing?
No.
You told me, you say that the timber is actually treated to to safeguard against fires. Convince me.
Yeah, when I talk about fire protection in this case, I mean that we do give it the primary protection against fires. You know, the thing about fire is that fire can catch any substance,
yes,
depending on the intensity. Mm-hmm. Even concrete houses, you can see that they always put in fire extinguishers. Why? Because they know that fire is a risk and something that can catch. But with the timber, there is what we call fire cladding. Timber is naturally having that cladding element, whereby if fire is to catch on it, actually, it can form a charring effect, which looks like charcoal. You see charcoal? Mm-hmm. That black substance. So when it forms a charring effect, it kind of slows the intensity of fire spreading throughout this.
Oh, catching the whole house. Yeah,
yeah. Meaning that even in cases of emergencies, if someone was to, if people were to be evacuated in a concrete house and a timber house, it would be easier in a timber house than a concrete house. Why? Concrete is a non-combustible substance, so it will produce fumes which are very toxic, meaning the person is suffocating. And for timber, it, because of the charring effect and the fumes that are coming out, they are not as much as toxic as those from the cement, meaning people can easily have more chances of surviving in a timber house than in a brick and mortar house. So to convince you about how this can happen, you have seen electric poles around the country. These are made out of wood. People are burning bushes and what, but it's so rare to find an electric pole that has been burnt by what?
By fire.
By fire. Why? Because of that treatment given to it, that cladding effect.
So the treatment still goes for 100 years?
Yeah, it goes for 100 years.
All right. To bring you guys up to speed, where we are seated right now is a house that has been built from beginning to finish, only with wood. It's a one-bedroom house, yes, situated here in these people's premises. Now, I want us to talk about this particular house. It's a single bedroom, has a bathroom, it has a kitchen area, and I think that is sort of like an office area. Talk to me what it takes for one to acquire this particular type of house. One-bedroom starters, let's say we are starting Njagala Nyumba, now I want a one-bedroom house. What do I need to go through? How would you guys take me through this? What are the technicalities of acquiring this particular type of house?
Yeah, Thank you so much for bringing up that point. Actually, the first requirement that we require you to have is you need to have land where you want to build, and that land has to be, you have to have the legal ownership of the land.
Definitely.
Yeah, so when you have land where to build, you can reach out to us. It's a housing. So when you reach out to us, we can give to you, we have a catalog of options where you can select if you are interested in this one bedroom specifically. We can, if you want a studio of 34.9 million, still the next step will be us signing a contract with you. When we sign the contract, from the time of signing the contract, we can do the construction for around 4 months. The house is
up. One bedroom?
One bedroom, even if it's 4 bedroom, depending on the wait list.
Okay.
Yeah, depending on how many people we have in line, from the time of signing the contract, up to the final time when we say that the house is done for you, the core and shell house, we can build it in 4 months. So we have the fastest construction cycle in the world, I can say, because actually,
man, which is cool.
No, actually, I can tell you that.
Are you sure in the world?
Yeah, in the whole world, we have the fastest construction cycle.
Easy housing.
Why? If you research about prefabrication, so it's the model of our construction. It's prefab. We make this house actually in the workshop. We bring it in halves and pieces. We assemble it on your site.
So each wall here, all the 4 walls here are prefabricated before they are brought on site.
Exactly. The entire house here is prefabricated in the workshop. The reason as why we chose that actually was to have control and high quality precision over what we are producing, compared to a structure that has been done fully on site, because there are things that you will never see when you are building the entire structure at a go on the site. But in the workshop, we take too much quality. We are taking control and looking into things that we may not foresee when we just bring the house on the site. So there is that kind of quality and control. So that's why
you're able to see, in case you're constructing, you're building these walls in the workshop, you're able to see where there's a kink, then correct it right there in the workshop. So whatever you bring on site is something that is nothing but quality.
Yeah, it's nothing but quality. So by the time we bring it here, we are bringing just pieces of the entire house. And that is what we call actually the saturality of the concept, whereby much as we have
clarity.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Assuming we have put it here in Ibugorobi, then after some period of time you change your mind and decide, I want to move to Mukono. This house, you can unscrew it, you remove all the screws, take it back to its original composition, you go and reassemble it in Mukono. So if you want to sell land, you are going to sell land differently.
Without your house.
Without your house, which you can never do with a brick and mortar house. So that's the most important bit about this. Even when they say you build in a long press, something like that, it is so easy to take away your house and put it in a right press.
See, there's this problem of girls that come to your home, or wives that come to your home and they don't want to leave. You just tell her, babe, let's go to the market. By the time she comes to the comes back home, the house is gone. That's just a joke, but yeah. I like the concept of the circularity, like you said. I think it's more suitable for people that are on the move.
Yeah, it's more for people that are on the move, and people who are interested in actually even having value, like depending on how the area is developing. You could have leased an area of land somewhere and you want to set up your development, you have calculated your investment, you are saying that after this period of time I'll be getting this amount of money, and after that I'll take away my houses and I would have got the money to buy my own piece of land. So you leave the leased area of land tight and then you take away the house. Yeah.
So I'm curious to know, like, because I checked the bathroom over there and you told us earlier on that you're preparing to tile it and then put all the fittings. Now the question is, you know, we all know that wood and water are like, you know, oil and water. So how are you going to make to convince me or ensure that wall there will stand the test of 100 years without water necessarily destroying the undercoating, which is the wood, over time?
Thank you for bringing it up. The reason why we do tiling in the bathroom is because we know it's a water environment, constant water environment. And so we do tiling on the wall because we know with the showers, water could be spritting over the wall, something like that. And due to the long-term exposure, you know...
Come down.
Yeah. If you see the process of how livers are formed, you see they cut through the log, but water. So that long-term effect can also be acted on the wood. But I can tell you that the paint works that we apply over these structures outside and the inside, they are all waterproof. But we want to give you something of extra strength. But in cases of the bathroom, for instance, there is a situation whereby even we can only tile the shower cabins, and you don't need to tile the entire structure, but only just the shower cabin. So tiling is just done because bathroom, there is too much spilling of water, and depending on the usage, that's why we do that.
That's quite interesting. So, and then this one bedroom, talk to me about the price.
Yeah. So this one bedroom house you are seeing here, it costs 41.6 million Ugandan shillings, still very affordable when you compare to houses of one bedroom that can go a standard modern. I'm talking about a modern house, a decent, comfortable house where you will sit, relax, and you don't have to have nightmares in this kind of a house. So
with matafari, they have nightmares.
Yeah, we have seen situations whereby people are saying that I built this house cheaply, but after some period of time you are seeing cracks developing over the walls. And you see, that comes, you are calling it cheap, but see what happens after some 2 years. But we are ensuring this is going to last a long period of time. So this one bedroom house is 41.6, and it comes with just a core and shell. Just have, like you have seen, the doors come with it. We use aluminium sliding doors and windows. They come with the mosquito nets installed. And
on the windows, yeah?
Yeah, on the windows and the doors.
About to ask, where are the nets?
Yeah, those design mosquito nets. So the interior doors can also be applied still on the same price. The paint works depending on the kind of colors you want. Outside you choose varnishing. Most of our clients actually, they say, I want a natural look of wood. You know, there are
like that drastic wood.
Yeah, there are many benefits that are attached to living in timber structures compared to brick and mortar houses. When it comes to the beauty, acoustics, the health, even the indoor air quality. Yeah, you see we are having very spacious windows, very spacious doors. And so that's so unique about it. So that's what comes with the price. But these additional options, they are not that much expensive. Fixing in the bathroom, fixing in the electricity. So, but we, like I said, we leave it out for you to make a decision. When you say, is the housing, you can do everything for me, then we can calculate and finish it up.
Kukulubia, ndegara otulambuze mko this one bedroom. Is it a wooden house?
A timber wooden house.
This one bedroom timber house, yeah?
Yeah.
Jango tutu wale.
Alright.
Everything here is wood.
Yeah, this is...
What is this? This down here, this
is
concrete.
The foundation which the house sits. It's made from upcycled plastic foundation. Plastics. We melt plastics and aggregates and form this block, because we are still reducing on the damping of plastics by giving value and making some kind of bricks, blocks like this. Okay. So this is, the house sits on several of these and it's raised above the ground.
How many, like 4 or 5?
Very many. This one's like around 13.
So you're saying that these are on 14 hinges?
13 of them.
13?
Yeah, but it depends on how big the structure is. This is our living room, as you can see, and here you can customize depending on how you want your orientation or the interior design of your house. You may say the TV will be there, or it will be here, But me, if I'm coming, I would like to come straight to the kitchen. If I have my fridge here, I get a drink. So if I have something to put into the kitchen cabinets.
So there is no sink here?
We are going to put the sink here. We have to cut here and put in the sink. So this is on set of its
is it, the plumbing is also going to be here?
Yeah, all the plumbing has been done actually. We are just left with putting in the sink. Our bathroom.
Oh yeah, yeah, okay.
This is our bathroom and you can see we have so far put already the cement board. So we shall have a toilet seat there and the sink could be there. Then here we shall have the shower cabins and whatever.
Shower cabins here?
Yeah, around here. So these are the points of connections.
This is very short.
You are tall. You are too tall. But it's going to be raised like this.
Oh.
Yeah, it's going to be raised like this.
Right, but water heater?
The water heater, yeah, around
here. So
yeah,
so
whatever.
House is for a rich guy.
No, it's for everyone. It's for everyone.
So what's there? That is the shower.
Yeah. So water will be spreading down there behind. There is a connection to the septic tank. So water will be flowing.
Explain to me the technical architecture that has been put here to make sure that the insulation is going to ensure that the water does not get in touch with the wood, or the wood does not get spoilt over time.
The beauty here, now you see this board, it's not possible to do tiling direct on the wood, but it's possible to do tiling on such a board, like a cement board. Mm. So that's why after this wooden layer, we have put this cement board, and after we are going to do the tiling over the walls.
Okay.
So even if water is spritting like what, you will see the beauty when the final product is done. So water will be just spilling. Water will be just spilling over the walls, over the walls, over the walls.
Like tiled walls.
Yeah, tiled walls. Even the same applies to the floor. So water will never get in touch with the wood anymore. Yeah.
Interesting, man. I was really, really. That's one area I was really very quizzical about.
Yeah, this is the bedroom. So in our design, depending on how you want your orientation to be, the bed could be put here, then you can have your wardrobe here. Then, yeah, you can also have something put there, depending on the design of your bed. Everyone has different design. So the spacious windows.
Yeah, from nets, yeah?
Yeah, with these nets. So don't worry about mosquitoes. There's no need to worry about mosquitoes. That one has been sorted and already in your price. Even when you want, we can put burglar proofing.
On that same price?
No. That is an additional price, but not that much. Okay. So these doors and windows, we can add burglar, further enhance. Yeah. Right.
So what about the floor, my guy?
This floor here is timber. It's timber. And the beauty about it for parents, if a kid falls on a tile, the damage the kid will get is very different from a kid who will fall on a wooden floor. Mm-hmm. Because wood is very soft. Even when a baby is falling on this floor, there will be less impact compared to the tile. So the floor is fully varnished and it's easy for cleaning. You don't need to worry that what about water? No, this is waterproof and fully varnished.
Right, maintenance.
Yeah, so maintenance is very easy.
You mop, do you clean?
You can apply a moist towel, yeah, but not with too much water, just to remove off the dust.
What does the too much water do to you? Because you said you treat.
Yeah, the too much water, of course, it will not make it rotten, but we don't want it to be messy.
This is a very interesting conversation, and I believe that with this information he has shared, you're able to make a choice for especially prospective homeowners, and I'm speaking for mostly the young people that are trying to, you know, have a thing or two to themselves. So going forward, I would advise that as you construct a house, keep in mind the cost and the type of house you're building and what that house is going to contribute to your environment. Are you taking down trees or are you helping in sustainability of your environment? My name is Francis Amokule, and this has been the Homes and Construction Show here on Urban TV. See you then next time.